Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Code Studio. So in this video we are going to learn that how to create a beautiful and amazing signature pad for taking signatures, and we will also see that how to convert those signatures into images and save them locally in your device. So before getting started with our coding part, let me show you how it is gonna work like. So when you will first run this app, it will ask for user permission. So as I have provided it earlier, so I can show you the same again, but here we'll start with the signature process. So as you can see over here, while I am writing something on the signature pad, it is having very smooth and beautiful flow for the signature movements. Okay. And if I click on the clear button, then our signature pad will be completely empty. Okay. And if I write something and if I click on the save as image, it will show you the preview and it will also show you the path where it has been stored inside a scaffold messenger. Okay. So let's get started. So for creating a signature pad, first we will need to import some dependencies. Okay. So for this project, we have used the Syncfusion Flutter signature pad, okay, for our signature pad. After this, to save our signature, we need the permission handler package as well. And to save our signature into a particular folder, we need the image gallery saver package as well. Okay, so after importing this three dependency, we will switch to our Android manifest XML file. So inside our manifest file, what we have to do, we have to write just this one permission. Okay. So because you will be storing the images inside your device locally, so we need to give our app those permissions as well. So to store the images, we need to provide it the permission of write external storage. And after writing this, we'll go to our main.dart file. Okay. So here we are calling our my home page class, okay, and this class is a stateful widget. So we have created a screen named signature screen, okay, and here we have created a stateful widget my home page, okay. Now the methods and the variables that you are seeing over here, we are going to discuss it step by step, okay. So first we'll get started with the UI part, that how to create the signature pad and this buttons, okay. So first inside our build method, we are having a scaffold, and inside the scaffold, we are having a column of widgets. Okay, we have provided some main axis and cross axis alignment to our column. And after this, we are having our signature pad wrapped inside a container, which is again wrapped inside a padding widget. Okay, so before getting started with our signature pad, first let us discuss about this Syncfusion Flutter signature pad. Okay, so this library is written in Dart for capturing smooth and more realistic signatures, and it is also capable for saving it as an image to sync across devices and documents that need signature. So this signature pad has the features of rich customization. Okay, like you can set the minimum and maximum stroke width of your signature. You can even set the stroke color as well. Then it provides more realistic handwriting look and feel. Okay. As I have shown you in the example, that the algorithms that are used to create this widget, okay, draw signature based on the speed of the drawing gestures along with the minimum and maximum stroke thickness, which brings a more realistic and handwritten look and feel to your signatures. And third, which is my most favorite, which is save as image. Okay. So you can save the drawn signature as an image to your device. Okay. Now if you want to save as a document, PDF, it is completely up to you, but we will be saving them as PNG images in our device. Okay. So let's get back to our coding part. So over here, as you can see, we have used our signature pad. Okay. Inside it, we have provided the background color, stroke color, minimum and maximum stroke width as well. Okay. And because this signature pad is wrapped inside a container, so we have also provided a we have also provided some decoration to that container as well. Okay, we have given it a border of gray color. Okay, now over here you can see a key attribute inside the signature pad widget. Okay, so you can see its value is signature global key. So now first we have to create a variable of global key and its type will be signature pad state. Okay, now global key is assigned to the signature pad instance. To call this method, to access its methods like toImage, toClear and so on. So to access the state of the signature pad, we have to make use of a global key. Okay. Now after passing our signature global key as the key attribute of our signature pad, now below this pad, we are having a row of two text buttons. One, it is having a save as image text and second is having a clear text. So, and both are having some function inside the onPressed method. Okay. So, before getting started with this method, first, we want that whenever user opens this app, so the device should ask them for the permissions. Okay. For storing the images from this app. Okay. So, that's why we have imported the permission handler package. So, import that particular package inside our screen. Okay. And then we have written a method name request permission, which is async. Okay. So what this line of code will do? This will ask the user, okay, for some permissions for this particular app regarding the storage. Okay. Now, according to the option selected by the user, whether he or she has allowed the app for the storage to access the device folders or it has denied it. So, all that particular status, okay, for the current permissions, okay, that we will fetch using this status. Then inside its bracket, we will pass our permission storage to string and we'll store it inside this final info. So, whatever the permission the user has given to the app regarding the storage functionality, we will fetch it inside this info variable and we will make toast of it as well. Okay. Now we'll go to this toast function. So what this toast function does, here we will pass our message as its parameter. Okay. And we are making use of the scaffold messenger. Okay. And it will show inside a snack bar whatever the message you have passed as parameter. As simple as that. So whatever permission user has selected, that will be shown inside this snack bar. Okay. So, if I hot restart my app, it will show a snack bar for my permissions. So, as you can see over here, it is showing permission status granted inside our snack bar. Okay. So, after writing this request permission method, we want that permission storage dialog to be asked very first when the user opens the app. So we will call this method inside the init state method of our class. Okay, so here we are calling our request permission. Okay, now after granting the permissions, now if the user draws some signature pattern over the signature pad, so as earlier we have provided two buttons, okay, save as image and clear. Okay, Now, if I am drawing something on this signature pad and now I want to clear the screen. Okay, I want to clear the signature pad. So, for that we have written a function name void handle clear button pressed. Okay, so to clear the signature drawn on the sign pad, we use the clear method. Now, since the clear method is defined in the state object of signature pad, we have to use the global key which we have assigned to the signature pad instance to call this. Okay, so that's where we have written signature global key dot its current state dot clear. Okay, so whenever user will click on this clear method, it will clear the signature pad screen. Okay, now our last method is to handle the action on our save button. Now here our handle save button press, we have made it async. Okay, now what we want to do on this method is that when the user clicks on save as image, so whatever content has been drawn by the user on the signature pad or whatever pattern is residing inside the signature pad only. We want to access only that particular area, okay, for making or for converting it into the image. So, to accessing only this signature pad area, okay, we will use the render signature pad object. Okay, so now render signature pad, it is a render object for signature pad widgets. Now, what is render objects? So, when Flutter draws UI, okay, it does not look at the tree of widgets, but it looks at the render objects. Okay, the one which controls all the size, layouts, and etc. for painting the actual image on your screen. Okay, so with the help of this line, we will be accessing our render signature pad. Okay, now after accessing it, we want to convert it into image. So we have named this render signature pad object as boundary. So we'll convert this boundary to image. Okay, the signature pad provides you a image to image method as well. So we can save signs to images using this method. Now since toImage method is defined in the state object of signature pad, so again you have to use the global key assigned to the signature pad instance to call it. Okay, so here we have already used the global key for our rendered object. Okay, so that's why we are able to access its method toImage method. Okay, now after converting it into the image, we are converting it into the byte data, because we will be saving our image as PNG. Okay. So I want to be explaining this line. Okay. You can simply just copy paste this line. Okay. How to convert your image to a particular format. Okay. And if our byte data is not null, so we want to provide some name to that particular file, which will be saving as PNG. So what we are doing? Each image should be having a unique name. Okay. So we are fetching the current time in milliseconds and we are providing the name as signature, then this time that we have fetched and dot png. As simple as that. So up to this line, we are having our image saved, okay, into a particular png format with a particular name. Now we want to save this image to our local image gallery. So that's why we have made use of image gallery object. So here we have declared a variable final result equals to await image gallery saver dot save image method, and in it we will pass our byte data dot buffer as unit 8 list. Okay, and we have also provided it the name which we have saved inside the name variable. Okay, and if our image have been successfully saved, that again we will show a toast. Okay, which will be having the path of our image. Okay. Now, earlier you might have seen then when we are drawing some image on the signature pad and we have saved it. So the preview of that image has been shown if it has been successfully saved. Okay. So when you will be successfully saving the image, so inside this result, it will give you a list of attributes. Okay. So among this list, there is one attribute name is success. Okay. So if it has successfully been saved, so we will access this is success attribute. Okay. And we will check whether it's true or false. Okay. And also after saving the image, we will also want to clear the signature pad as well. So that's why we have written signature pad global key dot current state dot clear. Now after this, we will check our is success variable. Okay. If it is successful, so we are creating a dynamic screen. Okay. In this screen, we will be having scaffold, app bar, and in its center, we are having a container. Okay. And in this container, we will show that particular image that have been saved to your device locally using the image.memory widget. Here, we will pass our byte data. Okay. Which was having our image saved as in PNG format. Okay, so to show that preview of the image, we will write byte data dot buffer as unit 8 list method. So here you are done with your complete working signature pad. Okay, let us draw some pattern. Okay, and I have saved it over here, and the path has been shown in the snack bar. So let me check whether it has been successfully saved. So we'll go to our images folder, and here you can see a folder has been created of the images of our signature images. So this was the last image that I have created. Okay. So we'll again create a new image. I'll save it this time again. So now you can see a new signature image has been added to our device folder locally. So I hope you might have find this tutorial informative, and if you like this video, then please do like it and share it. So till the next video, keep practicing and keep fluttering.